Hello friends, in this video let's talk about one of the important concept in Python: functions with arbitrary number of arguments. In the previous video we talked about what is a function, how to call the function, how to declare a function and how to call a function. So let me quickly write down. So we talked about declare a function, and next one is invoke the function or call the function. So with this all we talked about. So if the function is expecting like a two arguments, so a comma b, then compulsory while invoking you need to pass either a comma b, or also you can do the, you can initialize with the default values in the function declaration itself. Initialize the arguments with default values. You can do that. So this all we talked about it. Then what is meant by arbitrary number of arguments? See here, while declaring the function, I am not sure how many arguments I may pass while invoking. So while declaration, I'm not sure on how many arguments I may pass while calling. I may not pass none of the arguments to the function while invoking. So that time this arbitrary number of arguments is really helpful. Then how to declare that? So you need to declare the argument with a starting as star. So star A, it is nothing but a arbitrary number of arguments. So while invoking you may pass value to A or not, it's up to you. While invoking you can decide it. So one time you can call that function with arguments, the next time you can call empty function. So that function works because you are specifying arbitrary number of arguments while declaring. So let me quickly show you how to declare and how to make use of the functions with arbitrary number of arguments in Python. So slowly, if you understand here, slowly we are going into a complex programming. If you have any questions in Python, please don't hesitate and drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. Also please like and subscribe for more technical videos on Python. So let me quickly open Python IDLE. So this is the place where I do write Python programs. So let me quickly open a module or new file. Let's save this, because to run I need to save. Fun. Okay, so here I am going to write it. So first of all I need to declare a function. So let me declare a function with any name. So if you want to see some basic functions, let me quickly declare it. Sum of A comma B, this is a very basic function. Print 3 comma 4. Now let's invoke that function, print of A plus B. It's my mistake, A plus B. Okay, so now here sum of 3 comma 5. Now let's save this and run it. You'll be getting, one second, what is the problem? Oh, sum is a default. Oh, 3.5, not 3.5. It's my mistake again. 3,5. Okay, let's run this. Yes, you have a value here, 8. So now if you do not want to pass this, you can initialize with the default values. As I told you, equal to 2, equal to 8. So now let me pass this again. Even though I initialize it, let me pass again. Still I am getting 8. So let's remove the arguments which are passing here quickly. Yes. If you do not pass any arguments, so my interpreter considers the default values 2 and 8. So this is the general functions. Now I am talking about arbitrary number of arguments in the function. Then how to do that? So let me declare a very different function. Let's create one more function with a different setup. Now let us say def, that's a syntax. So dynamic, I'm just dynamic underscore function. Hope you know that, like, what is the purpose of function and so what is the use of the advantage of the function. So in the earlier video I talked about the detailed explanation about function advantage, usage, disadvantage and all. So I'm going to keep that link in the description section. Please go through that if required. Now let's simply put it this star, not it star, arguments or parameters, whatever it is. Okay, so I'm not putting a comma b, something like that. I simply kept star arguments. So now I can do this way. For, let us say, arg in these arguments, print arg. That's it. So this is the declaration of the function. So once it is done, now let's call it, let's invoke it. So I'm just simply keeping a comments to invoking arbitrary function. Just to improve the readability of the function. Okay. Now let me take it copy, or I need to use the same casing. Let's copy and paste here. Now let's pass the values here. So can I execute without any values? Yes, of course it works. Otherwise you can put it like 100, 150, 400. Now let's save it. You have two functions calling. This is the one default basic function. This is the arbitrary function. So now let's run this. Now you can see this. The default function is giving 10. The next function, if you really see this, if you want, I can comment this like this. I'm not deleting the code. Later I can uncomment whenever it's required for me. So here if you see, let me run again. Okay, now I got fresh output. So I'm passing 100, 150, 400. Do you see all the three lines it came? Because of I used a for loop. For loop every time in the next line. If you want to put it in the same line, this output, you can put it. So like I simply specify, comma, END equal to, let's put some space here so that you'll get everything in a single line. Let's enter. Now you see this, you got the output in a single line. So now let's not talk about that end and all. Now, so in the next call, so I don't want to pass any arguments. I want to run empty. I want to invoke the empty function. Does it work? Of course it should work, because that's what I'm telling you. It's a dynamic function. It should work with or without arguments now, because I made it as a arbitrary number of arguments. Okay, now let's run this. Let me remove this for time being. Let me comment this, so that make sure that I'm not getting any output, because this is commented, this invoke is commented, this invoke is commented, this is only there with empty arguments. Let's run this F5. Yes, you don't get any output here. Do you see this clearly? You don't have any output. It means that my function is running with arguments or without arguments. Now even I didn't specify the data type of the argument. So let me run this with let me run again of test 1 comma test 2 comma test 3. Okay, so let me comment this so that, yes, let's save this, run this. Do you see this? I got test 1 and let me remove this so that to get everything in a new line. Now let's run this. We got the output in every three lines here in different lines. So now it means that, so for these arguments there is no data type. It works for integer, it works for strings. Let me check for the mixed. Let's me check for the mixed one. T100, T1, test1, 240. Let's make this normal number 340, test2, T2 is nothing but test2. Now let's run this. I have two functions. Two times I'm invoking the same function by passing all strings, by passing mixed. Let's run this. Run module. Do you see this? Yes. Now my function works for integers, my function works for pure strings, my function works for mix integer and strings. So that is the meaning of arbitrary function. So it does not expect the fixed number of arguments. It works with arguments or mix of arguments or without arguments also. So this is one of the advantages of the functions in Python. So if you really talk about programming language, to get this behavior, you need to do some more coding. You need to write lot of lines of code. But here it's very quickly, it's very easy for us. We can handle easily in a Python. So that's all about functions with arbitrary number of arguments. So we will come up with a different video next time. That's all about it. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.